Well, joining us now is Trinamool Congress's Derek O'Brien, member of the Rajya Sabha. Derek, appreciate you joining us here on CNBC TV 18. Well, so far it looks like it is headed for a washout this winter session of Parliament. You, of course, allege that the AIADMK is coming to the support of the government to ensure that nothing gets discussed.
Well, why only blame the poor AIADMK?
You have blamed them, not me. You are blaming them in your tweets.
They are only the branch office. The head office is the BJP. AIADMK is only the branch office. So the branch office is doing what the head office is telling them to do. The BJP do not want discussions. Let me explain this to you in Parliament. In the two houses, up to 25 to 30 subjects can be taken up every day on 0 hour. So two houses, 30 subjects opposition can take up. Plus there are five subjects waiting to be discussed. Different opposition parties. For example, one, job crisis. Two, farmer distress, agrarian crisis. Three, breakdown of institutions like RBI, CBI and Parliament. Four, Congress have refiled. And fifth, are a price hike. These are the five issues on the table. We want discussions. So these five issues will not be discussed because the government doesn't want it. And every day we opposition has an opportunity to raise 25, 30 issues. After this, after the results in Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan, the BJP don't want Parliament to run, so it's obvious. What do? They put their branch office, which is the AIADMK, into the well, and every morning for 6 days, they've been disrupting. My guess is they'll carry on doing this, they'll carry on doing this, and suddenly when it comes to around about the 10th of January, BJP will want to pass some bills in the din. That also will be a problem. We will not allow them in Rajya Sabha to pass these bills. We are saying institutions are breaking down. Let me give you an example in Parliament. There are some many crucial bills. All bills have to be studied. They have to go for legislative scrutiny. These bills have not been studied either by the standing committee or a select committee. Dhoom dharappa, this is happening. This is not the way Parliament should run. And BJP, as the government, have to be responsible for running Parliament. Now they are responsible for shutting it down.
Okay, Derek, one of the issues I know that you've been tracking closely, so I want to ask you if you have any further information, because we are given to understand that the Cabinet has cleared amendments to the Aadhaar Act as well as the Telegraph Act. And apparently for the Aadhaar Act, it is prospectively to ensure that if somebody wants to voluntarily share their Aadhaar number with a bank or with a telephone company, they should be able to do so. Now, this was what was being discussed previously as well, but we are given to understand that perhaps these amendments could be moved in this session. Any information that you have, and what would your stance be on this?
Our stance has always been very clear. My chief minister has publicly picked up a mobile phone and said, I will not share my number. I will not share my Aadhaar number for a bank, a number for even a bank account.
Yeah. No, so but if it's voluntary,
I don't know. I don't know what these reports. See, this issue is, there are other problems also. Who is the revenue secretary? And who is the head of UIDAI?
Yes, they're the same people.
Is it the same person?
Yes.
What's going on here? What is going on here? We can raise all these issues in Parliament. I am not like one of those BJP ministers. I don't need to run around national television channels in the evening. They should come and answer these questions in Parliament. What's going on? Privacy has always been an issue. Aadhaar, privacy, I've always maintained, is the second issue. The first issue before privacy, it's not only privacy, it's about the marginalized, the weakest sections of the poor. The weakest sections of the poor are the most hurt because of Aadhaar. Then comes the privacy issue. So both these issues together, so if they're doing all this, and what is coming up in the Cabinet, I don't have any privy to the Cabinet. I don't even have privy to what's going on in Parliament.
It's been cleared by Cabinet. It has now taken in, up by Parliament.
Let me not focus on that because we don't have the details.
We don't have the details. So let me move to another issue where
the Congress Cabinet? What is Cabinet? What is Cabinet? Even Cabinet ministers are saying they don't know what's going on in the Cabinet.
Let me talk to you about an issue where Rahul Gandhi, the Congress president, on farm loan waivers has said that the opposition, not just the Congress, but all the opposition parties will come together to ensure that the Prime Minister announces a national farm loan waiver. His words were, we will not let the Prime Minister sleep until he makes that announcement. Is the Trinamool Congress going to support the Congress in its quest to ensure that this does in fact happen?
You're talking to the spokesperson of a party who has been in the forefront, the Trinamool Congress and Mamata Banerjee have been in the forefront of farmer rights, of agricultural rights of farmers, of land rights of farmers. You're talking to the Trinamool Congress, whose Mamata Banerjee went on a hunger strike as we speak, 4th of December. Today is what, 19th of December? 4th of December to 29th of December, 26-day hunger strike. That is in 2006. You're talking to the Trinamool Congress. Trinamool Congress have changed the way the land acquisition bill has the land rights of farmers. You're talking to us. You're talking to the Trinamool Congress, who made a promise 5 years ago in the manifesto that they will double farmer income in Bengal. We didn't double it. You know, we tripled it from 97,000 after meeting all expenses, C2 and meeting all expenses. Now the farmer in Bengal per family is earning triple, 3 lakhs. That's the Trinamool Congress for you. So we know farmers, we know farmers, we know what is the Bengal model for farmers. Farmer loans to be waived, lot of it already has been done in Bengal. So please, when you're talking to the Mamata Banerjee is in the forefront of so, the farmer rights, the agricultural rights, so and land rights of farmers.
So you don't need the Congress. You don't need the Congress to take up this issue on your behalf.
No, no, Shireen, if you're looking for a headline, you're not going to get it. Every party has a right. Every party has a right to place their own issues in Parliament.
Okay, let me.
I'll give you an example. Just because the Samajwadi Party and the Trinamool Congress together and the TDP have together given a notice on farmer distress and agrarian rights.
Yes.
That doesn't mean that the Congress don't care or the DMK don't care. Opposition is working together. Opposition is working together in Parliament. Opposition is working together in Parliament. That does not mean every opposition party is a photocopy of the other.
Yeah.
Trinamool, for example, in the last 4 days or 5 days outside Parliament, since we haven't got a chance inside Parliament, for us, three issues have been, one, two, three, we discussed it. One, our issue was jobs. Two was agrarian distress and farmer and farmer issue. And three is the breakdown of institutions.
Right.
That doesn't mean corruption and refile is not a major issue.
Yeah.
But that's the Congress's issue. So we're working together.
Okay. Since you said that you're working together, are you all working together on ensuring that Rahul Gandhi becomes the pivot around this opposition unity? That has been what the DMK has proposed, but we are given to understand that other opposition parties have not supported that idea. Where does the Trinamool find itself on that? Should it be Mamata Banerjee around which this opposition unity comes together,
all
or is Rahul Gandhi an acceptable choice for you?
See, all these issues will be decided after the elections. All I can tell you, I'm the Trinamool Congress spokesperson, so let me speak on behalf of Trinamool. After Vasundhara Raje got elected out, Mamata Banerjee is the only woman chief minister in Bengal. That's not so important. What is more important is she's a seven-term MP. She's the three-time union cabinet minister. She's the two-time chief minister of Bengal, elected MLA. And she's been doing the struggles on behalf of the people for 40 years.
Yeah.
I don't need to go. Nobody from Trinamool needs to go around with her credentials and with her CV. Her track record speaks for itself.
Okay.
So I think if someone has given his opinion, that may be his opinion. These issues get discussed within our All India Trinamool Congress working committee. My understanding is that all these decisions will be taken after the elections.
After the elections. On the issue of GST, because again, that has been an issue that your party has vociferously spoken out against, including your finance minister, Dr. Amit Mitra. Now, we are not against the GST. You have supported the GST, but you've been against the manner in which it was implemented. I know what you're trying to say, and that's exactly what I'm saying, Derek. My point now is that we've got a council meeting coming up on the 22nd. The composition of the GST council has changed because of more Congress representations on the council. You know, and one of the criticisms of the non-BJP states has been that the GST in India has become a sort of knee-jerk policy, and it seems to react to elections. It reacted the last time around to what happened in Gujarat, ahead of the Gujarat state elections, and the expectation is that it will now react to the upcoming 2019 elections. What's your own take on what you would now like to see in the GST council when it comes to rates, rate rationalisation, simplification? What's the Trinamool's point of view?
Well, one is the Trinamool's point of view does not depend, our stand on GST doesn't depend on where we sit. We have been the most consistent on GST. We've always been for GST as a concept, and we were very harsh, the harshest critics, when it came to the implementation of GST. Now, within the implementation of GST, you please look at the track record of Bengal and how my colleague, under the leadership of Mamata Banerjee, our finance minister, industries minister, Dr. Mitra, he has been played a very, very important role. What are we talking about? Just because one election is coming doesn't make something right or wrong. You please look at A, how West Bengal has implemented GST and how very well, and also please look at B, how much money are we owed as a result of all this. So please be very, very clear. GST to us, or so many issues, we're not like the cuckoo bird who flies in during an election and then flies away. We are with the people on the ground.
Yeah.
So we realize, we immediately flagged. Shereen, when it came to demonetization, when it came to GST, when it came to, you know, there's so many things where you see Trinamool will always be first. GST, we so strongly supported it. But once we saw implementation was hodgepodge done in a hurry, we raised the flag. Demonetization. Look at demonetization. With all due respect to all the other political parties in India, and they're all our colleagues, and we're all working together, but you please look at the track record. November the 8th at 9:30, 2016, who called it, quote unquote, withdraw this draconian decision?
Yes.
Mamata Banerjee. Please look at demonetization.
Yeah.
1 week later, when we wanted to march in parliament, nobody marched with us in parliament except Shiv Sena and National Conference. 1 month later. So now everybody has come around, including all the glorious macro economists of the world. And good, we're happy that what Mamata ji said on November the 8th, now you don't mind if we pat ourselves on the back a little and say, hey, we told you so.
Okay, Derek, before I let you go, you pointed out that we're unlikely to see action in Parliament till perhaps the very fag end of this winter session. But where does that then leave the space for discussion, debate? Is it, you know, what are we going to now see on part of the opposition to try and keep these issues alive in public discourse? What's the strategy?
That's a good question. What strategy can I discuss with you? They've appointed, after sadly the former parliamentary affairs minister sadly Anand Kumarji passed away, they've appointed a new parliamentary affairs minister. You know, I've met him for 1 day for 30 seconds. You don't even see him in the house. Parliamentary affairs minister has to come, leader of the house has to come, discuss with the opposition parties, hey, listen, how do we break this deadlock, what do you want? There's no discussion. Always remember, the house belongs to the opposition, but it's the government's onus to run parliament. This government knows its days are numbered. It doesn't want to have any discussion in parliament. So now they will faff around. Then suddenly, I'm suspecting on the last 1 or 2 days, they will come and try and pass some bills in the Rajya Sabha in the din. And lo and behold, God forbid if that happens, then there will be a bigger ruckus. But the bigger question is, institutions like the cabinet, institutions like parliament, institutions like standing committees, financial institutions, you know, the glory of these institutions have to be resurrected.
Right.
Because this pair of two who are running this government, not even a government, it's a pair of two, they're running this government. They're not running, you know, a little 800 square foot jewelry shop in Ahmedabad. This is the government of India, so it has to be run like that.
Very, very quickly, Derek, because you have, the Trinamool has in fact said that it intends to take up in Parliament the issues of institution autonomy. But I want to check if you intend to seek clarification on the statement that we saw coming in from Mr. Athavale yesterday on that 15 lakh rupees that was promised by the BJP into every bank account, suggesting that there were technical issues with the Reserve Bank of India, because of which that money has not been transferred, and the hope is that will slowly be done. Do you intend to seek a clarification on the statement that was made by the minister?
I think let's look at those kind of statements. I mean, they're so outrageous. So let's give him the benefit of the doubt. It's the Christmas season, and say he's got a great sense of humor. What else can I say?
All right. Well, Derek O'Brien, appreciate you joining us here. We wish you a Merry Christmas as well. Thanks very much for your time here on CNBC TV 18.